Hello, everybody. Andrea Majewski here with Dentalel Mobile Hygiene. So unfortunately, it looks like it's going to be a little while before I can start seeing all of my lovely patients again. I thought it was just going to be a couple of weeks, but I kind of have a feeling it might be longer, but let's hope not. But in the meantime, I would like to kind of teach you guys how to take care of your teeth at home. So much more than just the normal brush twice a day, use a mouthwash, try to remember to floss, those types of things. So what I want to show you guys is, what I really want people to start doing is, I'm just kind of grabbing one more mouthwash here, is start to use a mouthwash, okay? And I'll tell you why. Everybody should start, especially if you can't see your dental hygienist for a little while. So using a mouthwash can actually help to prevent cavities. Plus, if the gums are in bad shape, so if you're using your toothbrush and the gums are pretty red, they're starting to bleed, you know, that type of thing, the gums are in bad shape. So if the gums are red, sore, they are starting to bleed, this is the mouthwash for you. So this is a pH neutral mouthwash. This helps the gums and the teeth overall. So it does help to prevent cavities, plus helps to keep the gums a lot healthier than they would be if you didn't use it. So I would say to use this every morning and every night after you brush your teeth. Don't rinse with any water and no eating or drinking for at least an hour afterwards. Now, if the gums are in good shape, so you don't think there's any issues that way, but you are more prone to cavities, you need a mouthwash like this. So there is a 0.2% sodium fluoride, I believe. Yes, so that's the main thing that you need in a mouthwash, because that will actually help to remineralize those thinning areas of enamel, because those areas make it so much easier to get a cavity, unfortunately. And when we're stuck at home, we are probably not eating as healthy as we could be. I know I'm not. I am eating more chips and candy than I ever have before. Shh, don't tell anybody, but I do always use a mouthwash, so that's okay. So after you eat your unhealthy foods, rinse with water afterwards, because that will actually help to sort of take all of that sugary stuff out of there, but then always use a mouthwash. This takes it a step further and helps to kind of bring back those thinning areas of enamel from becoming too thin and then causing a cavity. Because every time we eat anything that has sugar in it, our pH in our mouth goes a lot lower. So we want our pH to be a pH neutral as possible. So 6.5 to 7. But anytime we eat sugar or anything acidic like coffee, tea, orange juice, our pH goes down to a 2 or 3 typically. To get a cavity, you only need a pH of a 5.5. So that's happening. But if you use a mouthwash right away, that pH moves back up again to a 6 to a 6.5. So you will not get a cavity. But the key is to use this at least every morning and every night to just sort of help to remineralize those thinning enamel-like areas as much as possible. And of course, brush twice a day. That is extremely important. And do not rinse after using your toothbrush and toothpaste. So talking about toothpaste, I do have a couple different things. So for children who are like ages 2, 3, you don't want them to get cavities, but they're probably eating more, you know, sugary things. This is excellent. This will actually help to prevent cavities, because it kind of does the same thing as the mouthwashes. It will help to neutralize that pH so they can't get a cavity. Even if they have like little tiny areas in there that may already be a cavity or become one, this will kind of help to stick to those areas and then hopefully won't get any larger. Now for those kids or adults who are cavity prone, or they even now have a lot of cavities that you haven't had haven't had a chance to actually get fixed yet. This stuff takes it a step further. So I will just show you guys the difference here. So this is kind of like a higher concentration, and this will actually help to really stick to those areas to not get cavities, and any tiny areas that you may have now hopefully will not get any larger. So there's different types. This is more for those like two or like 3 year old, even, you know, 4 to 6 years old. But even then, if you have a 3 year old that gets a lot of cavities, I would even say this one. But if you have any questions, let me know. Now, for adults, where cavities may not be your concern, but you just want to do as much as possible, and if you have cold sensitive teeth, this stuff is amazing. This will also help to, you know, stop any cavity areas from getting larger, and it just helps to keep the enamel as protected as possible. But for those of you who are wanting a teeth whitening toothpaste, this one is one of my favorites because this will actually help to take away any stain that you have. Plus helps to protect the teeth from getting more stain on top. This is what I actually use every day, twice a day, because I like to drink tea and coffee, and that will pretty much stain like crazy. I used to get my teeth cleaned every 3 months just because I would get a lot of stain. After using this, I probably have my teeth cleaned every 6 months because that, you know, stain doesn't come back as quickly. There's another toothpaste that I do like too. It's a activated charcoal toothpaste, which I can leave the link for you guys. I don't have any in stock right now, so that's why I can't show you, but that's also excellent. But not all activated charcoal toothpastes are made the same, so be careful. I will leave the link on the bottom for the one that I like. I probably use that twice a week, like just to kind of give it something a little bit more, but I use this one probably 2 or even 3 times a day. So many different types, you guys, toothpaste, mouthwashes. I do hope that I can see everybody very soon. I can't wait. But in the meantime, try to keep your teeth as healthy as possible. Okay? And if you have any questions, you just let me know, and I will see you guys in the next one.